Hi, I'm Seth Schomer, NMR FAM employee and co-creator of RNMR, an open source software package for viewing and analyzing NMR spectra. In this video, I'd like to give a brief overview of RNMR and explore just a few of its many features. RNMR was designed specifically for NMR research in the metabolomics field. This specification is best exemplified through RNMR's most important feature, ROIs, or regions of interest. For demonstration purposes, I'll use an example dataset with an ROI table already in place. This example is a set of two-dimensional HSQCs taken from a study of red blood cell metabolism, available at the RNMR homepage. ROIs are user-defined sections of a spectrum used for designating peaks. Before creating a new ROI, I'll overlay a heaped standard spectrum to identify some peaks. I'll change the contour color here to make the peaks more visible. If I zoom in, I can clearly see the position of the heaps peaks from the overlay. With my peaks identified, I can now create ROIs around the signals for heaps. Because ROIs are defined only by chemical shift ranges, they can be easily moved or resized. Once defined, ROIs can be viewed in multiple spectra simultaneously using the multiple file window. Each column in this window represents a single ROI. In each row, we can see the data from the selected ROIs in each spectrum. Here we can see the alanine peaks in each of the spectra. Notice how the peaks change throughout the experiment. Because each of these boxes contain data from within the ROI chemical shift boundaries, we are able to view these changes. This type of analysis would be much more difficult if we had to rely on peak lists. Data from the multiple file window can be summarized using the ROI summary feature. There are several options here. For this example, I'll ask RNMR to return the maximum intensity from each ROI in the dataset, and I'll normalize these values to the intensities from my heaps peaks. This data can then be exported for analysis using other programs or stored to a variable for analysis in R. As useful as the ROI feature is, it cannot stand on its own. With this in mind, RNMR includes a full feature set and an intuitive interface designed for easy access. Most RNMR functions may be accessed through graphical user interfaces, such as the Plot Settings GUI. In designing RNMR, one of our goals was to simplify NMR analysis by following the "what you see is what you get" principle. For instance, if I choose to display only negative contours, when I pick the peaks in the window, only the negative peaks will be included. Similarly, the contour threshold for two-dimensional spectra also acts as a peak-picking threshold. Because metabolomic studies usually involve the analysis of multiple spectra, another of our goals in designing RNMR was to simplify batch operations. I'll demonstrate this using the shift referencing feature. First, I'll set the new chemical shift values for the reference peak. Most RNMR GUIs, like this one, contain a list of open spectra on the left with options and functions on the right. So I'll just select the spectra I would like to reference, and then I'll click the region button to reference the peak. RNMR will use the maximum intensity from a designated region as the reference point, and will automatically adjust the chemical shifts for the selected spectra using the values provided. Of course, these spectra were already referenced correctly, so I'll select them again and restore them to their original state. To add to RNMR's user-friendly interface, we have also included a comprehensive set of help documentation. Help documents can be accessed by topic or through the RNMR user manual, which acts as a step-by-step guide. In addition to the unique features I've mentioned, RNMR also includes the standard tools common to most NMR data analysis software. Although the focus for peak assignment in RNMR belongs to the ROI feature, traditional peak-picking functions have not been overlooked. Several peak-picking options are available, complete with RNMR's customary emphasis on batch operations and usability. You may have noticed that RNMR runs through the R statistical computing environment. This was not an idle decision. R is not only free, it is open source and community-based. RNMR is just one of the many available packages for R, as you can see here. We've taken steps to ensure RNMR is fully customizable so that these packages may be used to augment features included in RNMR without creating conflicts or extra dependencies. As the R language is fairly straightforward, even novices may feel comfortable viewing and modifying RNMR functions to suit their specific needs. If you would like more information on RNMR, please visit the RNMR homepage at rnmr.nmrfam.wisc.edu. Here you can access download and installation instructions, example datasets, help pages and video tutorials, as well as contact information. If you've tried RNMR and have any issues or suggestions, please don't hesitate to contact us, as any feedback we receive is always greatly appreciated.